just so y'all know, at NMPBS, we've been turning our land segments into educational lesson plans for middle school students. And Mollie is the brains behind all of that. She's the one who turns our content into something that makes sense for teachers and students. We've got two lesson plans out there so far. Can you tell people what those are and how they might find them?
Yeah, absolutely. So for those of you that are not familiar with it, there's an incredible resource online called PBS Learning Media. And this is a place where teachers can go and download lesson plans and student materials that then match up with videos that have been created by various PBS related organizations around the country. But this is a really special one that's really focused on New Mexico. So if you go to PBS learningmedia.org and then search for Our Land, you'll pull up a series of different lessons. The most recent one that we posted is three different lessons on the impact of wildfires on forests, which is, as we all know, a really relevant topic right now.
I'm curious, you know, there's all sorts of age ranges. Why did you decide to focus on middle school students for these lesson plans?
Yeah, so it was something that after a conversation with Laurel, who's also at New Mexico PBS, there's sometimes a lack of resources for middle school students. And so these are issues that are relevant that students can see and touch and relate to. So it's really just a good fit for kids at that age.
So I know as a kid and even now as a grown-up, I will do anything to get outside and away from my computer or my desk. But I'm curious, aside from like the getting outside aspects of environmental education, why do you think that environmental education is so important, especially maybe for this middle school age group, and really why it matters for New Mexico students?
Yeah, so middle school kids tend to be really concerned about justice. They care a lot about what's fair and unfair. And environmental justice is one of those topics that they tend to really gravitate towards because it relates to both what's fair and unfair for people, but also what's fair and unfair for the environment and the world around us. And kids have a lot of empathy at that age. I think they get, middle school students get a bad rap because we all remember how hard it was to be that age. But they're an incredible group of young people in New Mexico that really do care about the world around us, that want to learn about it, that want to engage with it. And one of the really cool things about New Mexico is we have such a wide variety of different biotic communities, different ecologies, different geological settings that we can explore and see almost everywhere in the state. I mean, you look around, you can see mountains around you. You can see dry areas. So it's an amazing place for kids to get to explore.
So you've been an environmental educator for a long time. And I'm curious for, you know, maybe there's parents or teachers out there who say climate change is too scary. Forest fires, like, you know, these are topics that are too big and too scary. What would you say to those parents or educators?
I think first that your kids know about these things anyway, right? They're hearing about it. And I think a lot of times kids are made to feel very powerless in the face of these issues, especially when they're just being told about it on the news. They hear some story in passing and, you know, it's the end of the world. And I think by actually learning about it, learning the causes, learning the effects, and then learning what students can actually do to make changes in their own lives, to think about the future, to think about adaptations and mitigations, we're empowering them. So, you know, like most scary topics, you can't just hide it from kids. They're gonna learn about it one way or another. And by creating opportunities to have them engage with real facts, with the things that are happening around us in our environment, I think it's an opportunity.